We're not going anywhere else besides this place, right? I don't think so.
I don't know.
Yeah, we have to spend a few hours here. And the hotel is so close by too.
5 for 10.
5 for 10, 1 for 5.
Okay, 5 for 10, huh?
5 for 10. Oh. Alright, can you hear me?
Yes.
We're in the Shepherd's Field. We're not too far from the place where the Lord Jesus is born. This is a modern chapel that is built on an ancient cave or caves, which were identified where the shepherds were watching their flocks. And the angel appeared to them. They were scared. Told them, don't be afraid. I'm here giving you good news. Today, in the city of David, a Savior is born. And the sign will be made for you. A child wrapped with a swaddling cloth, put in a manger. Then multitudes of angels said, glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace be on earth. Later on, the shepherds said one to the other, let's go and see what they have been told about. And from here they went and met the Holy Family, told them what they had heard, the news about this child, and came back rejoicing, happy for what they had heard and seen that day. The fields, we're gonna see the fields, but this is the 1950s. Antonio Barluzzi, Chapel Franciscan Fathers, and guess who donated money, which nation?
Canada.
Canada. Canada. So that's why we have the Canadian emblem here. Canadians donated money in order to build this church. Three nice paintings here. One showing the shepherds watching their flocks, while the angel and multitudes of angels, and they are scared.
Familia
with the, of course, flocks, sheep, and goats. And in the far distance, you see the little town of Bethlehem. The second thing, the shepherds went and visited the Holy Family and told them what they have heard good news about this child. You see that Jesus in cloth in the manger, wrapped with cloth, put. And you can see that they are in the town of Bethlehem. The third one, we see in the far horizon, the city of Bethlehem, the town of Bethlehem, the little town. Up on top, the star of Bethlehem. Have you ever heard of the star of Bethlehem? 1400 star. Why? The one that you touched in the nativity, 1400. 14 generations from Abraham to David, 14 generations between David and his son, and 14 generations from the Exodus to Jesus. So the star of Bethlehem, they are 14 generations. And you see, the shepherds came back rejoicing, happy for what they had heard and seen. This is one of the smallest chapels. Represents a tent or a cave. Multitudes of angels and glory to God in the highest heaven. Luke 2 verse 14.
And the mountains in regard.
Oh,
Holy family.
So, from here the shepherds walked. And came back rejoicing, happy for what they have. That's what we are going to do. We have time. No, we're going to walk down to the cave. That's it.
Well, this I could take a picture of.
Yeah, I can get pictures from your camera into my computer too, and then put some pictures in
okay.
And put it all together.
Jesus was born, and then they put up
crepes.
Yeah, pick up the fires.
Three charcoal fire, and that's why it is black, dark.
Oh.
So, Lord, early Christians identified the peace. The Byzantines built chapel and monastery here in the 4th century. Logically speaking, this is a perfect place for shepherds. Location-wise, it is also a perfect place for shepherds. Why? We are here between the mountains and the desert. Couple of miles from here we reach the mountains. Couple of miles that direction we reach the desert. Yeah, don't block the door. Watch your head. So, for shepherds, of course, they stay here overnight. Then hot summer days, they go up to the mountains, which is cooler. Come back and stay overnight here. Rainy season, they walk a couple of miles into the desert, which is warmer and drier. So, logically speaking, this is ideal place for shepherds. Location-wise, it's ideal place for shepherds. Early Christians identified the place. Archaeologically speaking, we find ruins of the Byzantine monastery that was built here on the shepherd's field. So, at least we have archaeology proof since or as early as the 4th century. And of course, generation to generation from time of Jesus until the 4th century.
Oh, that quite scary.
So what we have here, mosaics that go back, mosaics that go back to the
haste, haste, bring him Lord, the baby, the Son of Mary.
Peter, sing it.
Walk careful if you want to go down there.
Huh?
Walk
careful if you want to go down there.
Mark is there.
It's a cave.
It's a cave.
With lions, tigers, elephants, and giraffes.
And giraffes?
Oh, yeah.
The giraffes
big
in there?
Yeah, the small
one.
Do you hear what I hear? A song, a song, high above the tree, where the voice is big against the sea.
This is Umbrella Amore.
With a voice is big against the sea. Said the shepherd's boy with the mighty king. Do you know what I know? If your town's born mighty king.
Over there, no one.
Should we take a picture?
Do you know what I know? A child.
It's not very big.
You can sit down.
Sit down. Yeah, have a seat. Do you know what tree is this?
Pine tree.
No.
Oh, okay. A pine tree.
A date?
These are pine trees.
Yeah. Yeah.
But this one here?
Vanilla.
Cherry blossom?
Almond?
No, it isn't.
Maybe
No, plums.
Do you know what's this?
The one that...
Oh, yeah, that. What is that?
The one that you bought yesterday.
A nut. It's a nut.
It's a nut.
Almonds.
So what kind of
almonds? Almond? I told you.
All right. Can you see the blossom or the flowers?
Yes.
Yes.
Next month, that will be green.
And?
Green almonds. Have you ever heard the term? Mm. Green almonds?
Yeah.
Okay, the green almonds, which is... soft skin and the almond inside soft. Mm-hmm. So you probably never seen it, you probably never taste it because it will be here for only a couple of weeks. Then the green almond, everything is edible, so you can eat it.
Edible?
Yeah. Later on it will be a shell.
Okay.
So April and in March that will be, or mid-March to mid-April, that will be soft green almonds.
Oh.
You can eat it all. Wow. Then after mid-April, May, that will be hard.
Hard and?
Hard. You need to break it. You don't break your finger.
And that's the almond inside?
Yeah.
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 And then they process them, and then our brother buys them and eats them.
And he forgets what they were.
What are you saying?
Can you see the almond?
Yeah. Yeah.
And now inside, what color is it inside? What color is it inside?
The forest.
Wow.
So we can actually
look at it from
here.
What we see there is the beginning of the desert.
Where?
That hill.
Yeah, that's the cliff. That's the African cedar cliff. The Rift Valley. So for shepherds, this is a perfect location. Rainy season, they walk through the valley to the desert. It's dry and warmer. Hot summer days, they walk through the valley up to the mountain, which is cooler. Tomorrow we're going to the Dead Sea, right?
Yes. Yeah.
We'll be passing next to Qumran,
yeah.
Where the Dead Sea Scrolls were found. Have you heard about the Dead Sea Scrolls?
Yes.
Yes.
A community called Essenes, Sons of Light. They call themselves a religious Jewish community that left the temple.
I think
it's different.
It's different?
We do have
because
two kinds.
No, we've got to go. That's what we're doing in the package.
Okay. So, a community that left the temple.
You can even go to blue here. You
can tell me about it. Doesn't that taste good? Especially in the end.
You will get pregnant.
Name him Almond.
Yeah.
Mm. That is genuine. Homemade. Polished made.
Call him bitter.
Yeah.
Bitter.
Call him
bitter. Really bitter.
Yeah.
So a community, there is just Jewish community, left the temple. They stopped going to the temple. As a Jew, they had to go at least 3 times during the feast in the year. 3 times to the temple. They had to. But this community stopped going to the temple. Left the temple, went very close to the Dead Sea. Being a religious community, they recopied the Bible, the Old Testament, and they wrote their community laws. 66 AD, the Jews in Jerusalem revolted against the Romans. Excuse me. So these people, the Essenes, put their scrolls in caves and hid them in, put them in jars and hid them in caves. The Romans, 70 AD, destroyed Jerusalem, the same period of time they destroyed their community center, the Essenes. It's just next to the Dead Sea. We didn't know a lot about the Essenes till 1900 years later. The year 1947. What happened? 1947. Through the valley, reached the Dead Sea with his sheep and goats. He lost a goat. So he was looking for his lost goats. He reached a cave he was afraid to enter. So he took a rock, threw it inside the cave. Accidentally he broke a jaw.
And he saw the...
No, you heard the noise.
Yeah. So so he found a piece of leather with some writings in Aramaic and in Hebrew. So he thought that he found gold, but he was disappointed to find the Dead Sea Scrolls. He never knew what these were. So he took them with him. Imagine, he wanted to do a pair of sandals. So he came to Bethlehem, and again, imagine the situation. He went to Assyrian Christian shoemaker. The population here, 2% Christians all over the country. Out of the 2%, very few families that are Assyrian Christians that still speak the Aramaic language. Can you believe that? Can you imagine?
And you got the right.
So he took it to a person from a family called Kandu, Kandu, a shoemaker, to do a pair of sandals. That shoemaker opened them. He's religious. It's Aramaic, and he knows how to read it. If he took it to a Catholic one, he wouldn't know. Or Greek author. Can you imagine this? So it's part of the Bible, the Old Testament. So he paid him the price of 2 goats.
2 goats.
2 goats. Then he showed them to the Assyrian patria. Then they were sold to the US for millions of dollars. Here nobody knew archaeology then, 1947. In the US, of course, they found out these are 2,000 years old. And yeah, excavation started, they found more and more. And now it is.
Yeah. Government supported the Palestinians, helping the Palestinians. The USAID, they built, they built roads between the cities, because even if the Palestinians want to build roads, they cannot, because Zone C is under Israeli control, and they were left on. They were left narrow roads, and they became dangerous road to travel from one Palestinian city to another. So the U.S. government decided to build there. Yeah, to stay there.
Thank you.